What is up, everybody? This is huge. This is a big video right here. We're talking about the YNW Melly situation, and we actually have the photos that the police took at the crime scene. And warning, there's some graphic photos here, but if you haven't seen my first video that I did where we went over the three key pieces of evidence, I'm gonna put that video in the description below. When they first released these photos, immediately what I did was I wanted to see their bullet trajectory theory. I went to the back seat to see how they believe the bullets penetrated every object in the car. Now we get to see how the police map it out. So this is the back seat, and these are strings. So this is a technique they call stringing. Sometimes they use lasers. Now what they do is they use these to recreate their theory of the bullet trajectory. YNW Melly allegedly sitting in the left back seat. This is Juvie in the back right. Sack Chaser in the front on the right. And of course the driver, YNW Bortland. Now the police, they have to prove beyond a shadow of a doubt that Melly did the killing. Their theory is that the killing happened inside the car, and then he got out and shot up the car to make it look like a drive-by shooting. The police believe that Melly delivered two fatal headshots, killed Juvie and killed Sack Chaser. This right here is a headshot theory, but Melly is sitting on the left-hand side. Tell me how he delivers this shot the way that they've mapped it out from the left back seat, right? He's over here. What is he, Mr. Fantastic? He reaches his hand around behind here and delivers this shot? Tell me how that makes sense. Bullet holes here in the back seat, consistent with a shooting from behind the car. This is the window completely busted down. I think this is the car pulled over at the hospital, I believe, the next morning or something. Now this is where it does look suspect for Melly. Investigators found 40 caliber shell casings on a road that was not the original road where they were told the drive-by shooting happened on. So there's a conflict of statement there, or there's more to the story that we all don't know about. And of course, this doesn't look good either. This is what I call the magic bullet. Police found a 40 caliber shell in a plastic bag right where Melly was sitting. And this shell apparently matches other shells at the crime scene.
Oh, that bitch recording. Heard he caught a body, but that does not mean shit to me. Got two on me, got two on me.
When the rock star Alice Cooper made a song about necrophilia, where he told a story in detail about having sex with a dead body, do you think that the police showed up at his door the next day like, got him? Melly releases the song 223 and now everyone's in my comments saying this song is proof that he did it. No, it's not. If you're a rap fan, you want freedom of art and freedom of speech to exist without persecution from the government. End of story. So no, that's not proof and it's not a confession. Alright, moving on. Now if you think Melly's guilty or innocent, the one thing that everybody has to be wondering is, why would he do this? The police don't have a motive. They haven't provided a motive. And I got a bunch of people commenting, you don't need to prove motive in court. They're right. You don't have to prove motive. However, it's probably a good idea to prove motive to a jury that Melly would want to kill his childhood best friend since kindergarten instead of this being a drive-by shooting. There's no weapon. There's no witnesses. There's only circumstantial evidence and a bullet trajectory theory.
The big news in the YNW Melly case is the government is seeking the death penalty. They have submitted a long list of reports and experts for everything except for one thing, and that's bullet trajectory. They have not submitted a report or named an expert on the bullet trajectory.
So basically, the government doesn't even have an expert to prove that theory that you saw at the beginning of the video about the shots coming from the back left seat. Interesting. People want to know, why would Melly be framed or wrongfully accused by the police, right? The police are angels. They don't do this type of stuff. If you're asking me to come up with a theory why Melly would be wrongfully accused, I could easily do it. Florida is the third most corrupt state in America. Last month, a Florida police officer was caught planting drugs 100 different times. This is called laddering, which is the amplification or multiplication of charges. The reason they do this is to boost their performance. The better the department does, the more funding they get. Florida's got more incarcerations than any other developed country. Let's tie this all back to the Melly case. There was a murder of a deputy in YNW Melly's county. Now the police were looking at a couple suspects, one of which was Melly. They didn't pursue that case, we don't know why. Maybe because it wasn't him, maybe because they didn't have the evidence, but a sheriff died. And all of a sudden this case involving Melly just magically drops into their lap. As it stands, that's just a conspiracy theory. I don't want you taking that and saying that's what happened, but that's the whole point. The police's theories don't look good either. Everyone online is going, YNW Melly's guilty. And I'm over here like, yeah, but do we even know that? Like, let's try and know. This dirty face rapper just looks guilty. His name is Demons. Whoa, 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 chill, dude. Anyways, that's all I got for this video. Subscribe with notifications on. See you in the next video.